confusing out there with all the different types of machines to work out on and workouts themselves. Well, today I'm going to show you a great piece of equipment that you can work out on and work out your whole body with just this one thing. It's called a Bosu ball. Da-da. There it is, right there. What do you
it's
think, like
Deb? It's half a ball.
It's half a ball.
Half ball.
That's exactly what it is. It's okay. It's part workout exercise ball right here, and then part platform. And Bosu stands for both sides utilized.
Oh, really?
The ball.
Oh my God.
And the platform.
Oh, no.
And I'll be showing you. And the beauty of this, Deb, is that this thing right here obviously creates a very unstable surface for you to work on no matter what exercises you're doing. Because the stable is so the surface is so unstable, you're engaging more muscle groups, right? So you got your stabilizing muscles, you got more core muscle.
Have you guys stood on these before?
It's not easy. And you're going to get more of a workout in a less amount of time. It's
okay,
very, very efficient. So we're going to start with just a really basic balancing exercise because balance is such an important thing as we get older, but also working with the Bosu ball. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to step on here with one leg, okay? You want to engage that core, and then you're going to bring that other leg up. And you hold it as long as you can. And as you do that, you feel your foot moving around.
Yes.
It's okay to shake it first. Look at my concentration.
What are you supposed to do with your arms?
Well, you can
Karate
just keep
kid?
It.
I know.
They're just there to help you balance
I don't
it
know
first.
What to do with
you're
my
working
head.
On the core and the stabilizing muscles. And then you try the other one.
The
step on there.
Oh, okay.
And the more, believe it or not, the more you engage that core, the more stable you are. If you let your core go, it's harder. You're going to be waving your arms around.
So what is this doing? This is
working on a lot of the ligaments and the tendons.
In your feet?
In your feet, but also don't you feel it in your abs right
I
here?
I feel it in my abs,
Your
yeah.
core is working so hard.
And kind of in my calves as
we should
well.
Just hold
oh,
on to each
yeah,
other.
Yeah.
Help each other out. Okay, so that's just the first step. So you want to spend some time doing that. And like I mentioned, it's really okay if you shake a little bit at first. One of the reasons that I love personally using this, I'm a pretty fit guy, but my balance is not great. So as I'm getting older, like I like to do things like a paddle boarding out there.
Right.
Paddle boarding's hard for me because it involves a lot of stabilizing muscles and balance. Working out on a Bosu ball would be great for that.
I bet it would also help you with yoga.
Yeah, yoga for sure, all
like,
these
you know,
poses
yeah.
and all that. Okay.
Okay.
We're gonna get going with the first actual exercise here. That was a little bit of a practice warm-up.
Oh.
We're going to get into the squat. So we've talked about squats on the show before. It really typically works your quads, your hamstrings, your glute muscles. But with this, it's going to engage a whole lot more, even your calves. You're going to go down with your legs fairly close together, and you're going to keep that core engaged. If you can get all the way down where your upper legs are parallel to the floor, great. If not, don't worry. Just go down as far as you can. No pressure, slow movements. And you're going to be working your abs.
Yeah,
you're
going to
be working your hamstrings, your quads, even your calves, because if you feel your toes going forward to balance, here, get a shot of my feet. As you're going down here, you could be balancing while you're going forward and back and forward and back and side. You're getting all these supporting, engaging muscles, a little something like that. So you want to do, in general, maybe sets of 10, sets of 12 to start, as far down as you can, slow movements like you're sitting in a chair. And remember again, you don't want to be leaning forward like this when you're doing a squat. You want your upper body
as upright as possible. Is the idea to keep your feet flat, or do you want them moving around like
that? Well, I mean, when you're moving around, if they're flat, it means that you have pretty strong supporting muscles. So as you do this, you should be moving your feet less and less. All right, let's get to the next one here.
Okay.
Deb, we're going to move
I
our guy back.
Dismounted.
Do a little upper body. We're still going to be using the same side for now. Feet in front.
Okay.
And your hands on the Bosu ball. And then the further your feet go out, the harder this next one's going to be. These are tricep dips. You're going to be like, your hands are going to be moving around, supporting you and balancing you. And as you go
straight
down.
Straight legs
you're
or gonna, bent?
Bent leg. If you put straight, it's going to be a little bit harder an exercise. So if you want to really kind of burn it a little bit more straight, to start with, I'd recommend a little bit bent, just like this. And you just lower down slowly. You want your elbows to go straight back. You don't want them flaring out like that.
Oh,
that's
boy.
Really hard on the shoulders. Straight back, chest straight, chest up like that. A little bit lower, and then you can walk your feet out as you want, but as you feel, you're getting triceps, you're getting shoulders, you're getting chest, you're getting abs when you're doing this.
And we should also point out, if you are going to be doing any exercises, you should first obviously consult with your doctor before you do
any of
these.
Yeah, thank you for saying that. You're absolutely right about that. Okay, so that's tricep dips. Okay, a little bit of lower body we did. We've done upper body. Now what I want to show you is some of the exercises that you can do with the other side of the Bosu ball.
Oh.
So go ahead and flip it over. Exactly right.
So this is the Sue part.
Sides.
Now, you just grab a hold of the edge of the platform, just like this. Debbie has a little technique. Show them what you did, Deb.
Well, I did this
You had
earlier.
Your hands on, yeah, because
on here.
You actually have
like
to
that.
Balance even more like that. In this sort of plank position, you bring one leg up, and if you can, you jump change. It's called mountain climbers. And that's great. And if that's too hard for you, no problem. Just step one up, step one back. like that. But if you can, you do it. And this is going to be good for cardio. This is good for your core again. You're balancing your chest for sure.
Yeah.
Even your shoulders.
Your shoulders for sure.
Oh, wow, that really
but can. you will burn out pretty quickly with that bad boy right
you're
there.
You're not kidding.
You guys good?
Woo!
We got time for one more. I want to show it to you. Okay. Here we go. This is just a regular plank, everybody. It's like a plank on steroids. So look at me, I'm out of breath.
All this I know. Talking.
And you're holding it in place like this. If you work it around, you're using so many of your balancing muscles. Again, chest, core. You feel your core? Who feels your abs?
Yeah, yes. Definitely.
So much so. Yeah, it's just fantastic. Hold it for as long as you can. Take a break. Hold it for as long as you can. If that's too hard, do a knee plank. You know, with your knees down just like that. Well, if you want to take it to the next level, yes, you can lift your leg, but don't arch your back when you do that. Just really squeeze your glutes one at a time.
Oh, that feels good on your tushy.
A little something like that.
Oh, my goodness.
You can find these moves at HallmarkChannel.com. And even more moves like this with the BOSU ball online.